Typhoon Utor made landfall approximately 1550 locally this afternoon, just west of Zhapo Island in Guangdong Province, China. Winds estimated at landfall about 220 kilometers per hour, waves up to about 7 to 10 meters high. Extreme weather videographer actually positioned himself in the right front quadrant of this storm system there on Zhapo Island to document this storm as it came ashore. And you can see here the debris flying around, plenty of damage to be had from this storm system. Another thing I would like to mention, take this video as a tool for which you should not be doing during a typhoon, a hurricane, or a cyclone for that matter. When these storms hit, if you cannot evacuate, please take shelter in a sturdy building. Do not be out on the streets. Do not be trying to ride your bike anywhere. Just wait until the storm passes before you try to get to where you need to go. This is absolutely dangerous. I'm surprised we did not see anybody get injured here. So a very serious situation, and definitely take this as a tool of what not to be doing during these storms. Needless to say, there has been damage recorded across much of southern China. A ship actually sank about 80 kilometers southwest of Hong Kong. 21 personnel on board all were rescued via helicopter, but the pilot did say when he arrived that the ship was tilting at 90 degrees already. Some people were already in the water, but thankfully everybody was rescued from that. Several injuries also reported in Hong Kong. One person injured via a communication tower actually falling on them. But the good news, the bulk of the heavy rainfall, those gusty winds, remained southwest of Hong Kong, although there was some wind gusts recorded up to about 130 to 140 kilometers per hour there on Hong Kong Island. So you did see some strong wind gusts blow through there, but for the most part, the city was spared. The roughest stuff reserved farther down there towards the southwest. Actually, in Hainan Island, along the northeastern periphery of the island, we saw rain reports up to about 200 millimeters in the past 24 hours. Right near the center of the circulation of the storm system, some rain reports about 150 millimeters just within a few hour span. So some very heavy rain totals. Still a very serious risk of flooding out in this area as the storm does continue to move off there towards the north. Now, the good news, I mentioned that it was Typhoon Utor, but technically speaking, at the time of making this video update, it has been downgraded to severe tropical storm Utor, with winds of 60 gusting up to 85 knots, pressure at 975 HPA. Typically, JMA does reserve typhoon status for 970 HPA or lower, so it's just above that threshold. Still moving off there towards the northwest. If we look at it in the forecast, it rapidly decreases in intensity here. That's what you're going to have with a landfalling tropical system. It gets cut off from its fuel source down here towards the south. Drier inflow from the high pressure that is dominating central China is really going to influence, and I'm expecting it to quickly weaken out throughout the next 24 hours. But all that energy picked up by ocean here, it has to go somewhere, and it's going to be drifting off towards the northwest, especially right near the coast. We still could be expecting about 200 to 250 millimeters here throughout the next 24 to 48 hours. So very severe risk of flooding along the coastal areas of southeastern China. You see this continuing to wander around here, dropping some heavy rainfall through Friday and possibly even in the Saturday morning. The winds will die down, but there's still going to be a lot of heavy rain. Moisture inflow from the south there will continue to enhance it. So really, the threat through the next several days, even though this event is starting to taper off, there's still the very high risk of some severe river flooding and low-lying area flooding even a little bit farther in. As the Utor does continue to weaken over southern China, I do want to remind everybody that it did slam the Philippines earlier on this week with winds gusting up and over 250 kilometers per hour. Winds were actually stronger when it made landfall in the Philippines than here into southeastern China. So you just see that footage from earlier on and take it and put it over here where some of these buildings could not withstand those damaging and violent winds. 90 to 95% of the town of Casiguran, where these photos are coming from, was completely damaged or destroyed. Down in the description below this video, I'm going to put a link to the Philippine Red Cross if you want to help out the people there in northeastern Luzon recover from this absolutely disastrous and destructive storm system that has left at least 7 people dead, more people still missing out here in the northern Philippines. But that is all for right now, everybody. Thanks again for everybody that has followed us from start to finish on this special coverage of Typhoon Utor, prior to it impacting the Philippines all the way through that event and now here into southeastern China. We really appreciate all the feedback, all the photos, all the information everybody has given us along the way. Thank you, as always. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please post them down in the comment box below. And as always, stay safe out there and have a good day wherever you are. Bye.